Hello again, Anders Christensen here. I would like to show how to use Postman for demonstrating REST JSON. As we see it right now, we have a prototype I can demonstrate. And I'll show this on the screen I have here. What we will do is, when you have Postman, you will see here at the top, you have the HTTP request, all the different things you can do here, the URL that we're working on. And the way it is organized from a URL perspective is that, well, my server is installed on this laptop, and so this first URL part is sort of fixed. And then everything we do right now, I'll show, is on the REST, which is called REST, and then that you will see I'll modify this this part. The management servers request, if I say get to that, then I'll get an array of management servers. Now there's really only one management server here. And they'll see all the fields that we have on the management server with name, time zone, computer name, and ID, and so on. There'll also be some links. And we have a link for the management server itself. If I take that, it'll basically show that in compared to just saying I want to get all management servers, I can get just the information for one management server. We'll still get the same data, but now we don't have an array, but simply the data for one management server. So this is the simple information for one. Now you might say, well, there's a lot of more information on a management server than just this. Yes, we have divided it into resources below this. In order to find out what those resources are, you can type in resources as a parameter. And then when we do this, resources, if I still write here, then what I will get is I'll get a list of the sort of subcategories, the sub resources that are available. You can see recording servers, the different groups we have, and basically all the stuff you know for the management client on the left-hand side navigation. If what we also is here, we have basically flattened out the system. So even though we can have, for example, hardware on multiple recording servers, we are flattening it. So if you ask for hardware, you will get an array with all hardware on all recording servers. So you don't have to sort of find out where this hardware is located. This is also the same for a camera. So if I ask for cameras, I'll get all the cameras that are available here. And we can see all the information that you can read out and you can modify. I can also get this specific camera, so I only get information for one camera. So I type in the cameras slash the grid, and then I get the data for one camera. Again, you'll see that the amount of information you have is sort of the high-level information, get going. But if you need detailed information, again, there'll be a way to ask for what resources do we have here. And then I can look into saying that I have the camera and I have a bunch of resources, device driver settings, PTZ, streams, and other things, which is also something you could probably recognize from the management client tabs that are available. So if you want to go into, for example, device driver settings, you can actually ask for this specific device driver setting for the given camera, which would then have device settings and the same. Let's start out without this. Then I get the settings that are part of the specific camera and that I actually can vary from camera to camera. So you have some of these things. Some of this is maybe a little bit strange because we have XML encapsulated into these properties, but there's also a lot of stuff like resolutions and other things that are well known. If this needs to be modified, then the idea is that we also have something called definitions. And if you ask for definitions on this specific, then what you will get is you will get a list down here. Oops. What happened? Oh boy. What did I click now? Scroll down here. Here. So here what we have is a definition of something where it says mirror image. What can I do with that? Well, I can set it, so it has can set true. It's an enumeration. And then the option enumeration is actually yes and no. So this is a little bit simple. Rotation, it's also an enumeration, but the values can be 0, 90, 1, 180, and 270. So it's basically the degrees that the rotation of the camera is. So it's like the position of the camera, which means you have four choices if you like to validate it. Modify it. If you're doing a UI or application that needs to change the configuration, you can look up the possible values using this definitions part, and figure out exactly what possibilities you have doing this. Let's try and do something where we actually create something. If we go in and say we want to look at basic users, we'll see that we have no basic users. Okay, so I like to create a basic user. We use the post command and basic user. Now this is not a valid command, so what happens? What happens is that it says, okay, you do a post, you really need to provide, it tells me, these three parameters. Otherwise, it cannot create the basic user. So I need to move this down a little bit. And then we'll go in and say we have JSON. I can put this in that didn't cut and paste of the format, and I need to change the name. A DevCon user. And I'll do a password that I know is not good enough. But let's try this out. Now it comes and say that the password doesn't meet the complexity, which is something that is, you know, we're validating in the management server based on the Microsoft settings. I guess something like this is probably going to be no. Okay. What do I need? Do I need something else like this? Now, why wouldn't it do this? Okay. So it would take this whatever strange password. And now I have a basic user. If I then just go and say get basic users, I'll then see I have one user. And this is the ID and the link of it. The basic user will also be assigned a GUID. Now again, I can also go in and say that if I get this basic user specifically here, and I do a get on this. So I basically have the same thing. You will also see that you do actually not read the password. We'll don't have time to explain this today, but there's a way of changing password specifically. But let's say I want to delete it. Then I can use the delete HTTP, delete, and this URL. This part is not used. Success. That means that, of course, it deleted the basic user, and that's done. So you can do a full management of objects that you have, well, access to manage using this. You can also, if we go into recording server, and say I want to see all recording servers. I get a list of recording servers. I get hold of one of them. I only have one, so that's kind of easy. Then I want to see what task I can perform on this. So first I want to say get recording server, I have it here. Okay, then I can say here we go. So what at the bottom is we have a list of possible tasks we can do here. So for many objects, it's not a matter of just get and put. It's like we want to start a task that can do certain things that are more complex and might need more parameters, like a function or method. We call it tasks. You get the name of the task here, and you can basically make a post where you say task equal to these names here, and then it'll run those things. These tasks are basically the same thing as you have in the context menu in the management client for moving hardware, scanning, add hardware, and so on. You can do all the tasks you can do in the management client. You can also do those through this API. So this is what I wanted to show on the Postman. If you'd like to participate in the beta program, then you can send us a mail on developer@milestonesys.com. And if you drop us a mail on this, we will invite you into our closed group on the developer forum, and we'll communicate on what's going on that forum. Thank you.